Welcome to the glass plate. Today we're going to do a difficult example. Are you ready? We're going to consider an industrial process. Imagine that you need to make small alumina spheres. You can try and grind alumina, but you can also use a melt and then spray droplets in a big tower, let these droplets fall down and hope that they cool before they hit the ground. Just for the fun, we're going to use some arbitrary numbers. Assume that this is only 80 degrees Celsius. Sure, in practice it will be much higher, but we take this as an example. And the question that we have is, from which height do you need to let it fall down so that when it reaches the floor, it's only 30 degrees and you can package it? To find out, we need one, to estimate the terminal velocity of this particle, and two, let me take another color, we need to estimate how much heat it will lose. So a phi sub q, and we'll concentrate on this one. Terminal velocities we have seen. If we take the particle alumina with a diameter of about 1 millimeter, then by now you kind of know how to do it. Estimating the velocity gives you something like 8 meters per second. But that's not the issue of today. We're going to re-examine the heat loss from this warm alumina particle that is falling through air of 20 degrees Celsius. So I'll redraw the particle, somewhat bigger. Heat is going out because there's a driving force from the temperature of the particle towards the temperature of the air, which is fixed at 20 degrees Celsius. And I need to know what this flow, or better, this flux is. And we know how to do it. It is the heat transfer coefficient times the driving force, T of the particle, minus T of the air. To find H, I better look for this situation of a particle moving through air for the corresponding Nusselt number. If you look on the internet, or in books giving relations about this, you can find an expression for that. That expression depends on the velocity of the particle. It's kind of logical. The faster it falls, the better is the flow, the higher is the flow around it, the better is the cooling. I did it for you. And let me check on my piece of paper. With this particle falling at this velocity through air, the Nusselt number that you can find is 15. Recall, it's a dimensionless quantity, it's just a number. But I need to go back to H, and therefore I use that H and Nusselt are related by this relation. Nusselt times lambda over D, and it's the lambda of the air because the flow resistance is in the air. And again, I computed that for you. I found 353 watt meter squared Kelvin. Here I have the numbers. Now I need to set up the balance. I didn't do that so far. I just backed out what the transfer coefficient is. So I need an energy balance for this. And as this sphere is cooling, it's an unsteady balance, making the problem much more difficult than steady state problems. But let's not shy away from that. And let's just set up the balance. I need an energy balance for this particle falling down. It has an energy rho Cp V times the temperature, and the temperature is changing over time. So the unsteady part is this term, and it is losing heat via its area with the flux that we have now modeled. So let me put there a line. And I need to solve this equation. And I'm going to show you quickly how to do that and then give you the end result. I split variables. This phi q contains the temperature. So when I substitute this, this part, T minus T of air, is moved from this side below that side. Just write it out for yourself and see that I can do that. Everything else is moved to the right-hand side. So I got my minus, my A, over rho Cp of the particle V, and I have left over, of course, I shouldn't forget it, the H, the transfer coefficient. And then this dt is also moved to that side, times dt. I can solve this by integrating. And if I integrate, I get here the logarithm of t minus ta equals integrating this part, and this part is easy because there's only integration for t and the rest is constant. So this gives me a rho cp v h times t, and I shouldn't forget the integration constant because I'm integrating. Integration constant can be found by the initial condition that at t time equals zero, the particle is at its original temperature, which we set here at 80 degrees. And I call this t zero. So rather than writing this k, I can substitute, and that turns out that you need to divide here by t zero minus ta. Now I get a closed expression. I know n temperature, air temperature, starting temperature. I know h, rho cp for alumina, I can look up. A and V is the area pi d squared for a sphere, volume pi over 6 d cubed. I can fill that all in. And then I back out that the cooling time equals something like 2 seconds. And thus, since I know how fast the particle is falling, the required height is V times this t cool is 16 meters. Which is doable, and these processes exist in industry. So let me recap what we did. We realized that there's heat transfer because there's a driving force. I took for that the heat transfer type of modeling. I looked for this situation at the Nusselt number in books or on internet. Once I have the Nusselt number, I can compute the heat transfer. In doing so, I assume that the resistance is on the outside, not in the particle. And I need to check that, but believe me, it's true. Once I have that fixed, I can set up my energy balance, which is unsteady, try and solve it, that requires quite the mathematics, back out the solution, compute the time, and hence have my answer. Try and repeat this yourself and see whether you can follow all steps. Good luck.